In this video, we will demonstrate how to prepare 1 liter of culture media. We will weigh out the powder, add the water, mix, and sterilize in the autoclave, then pour into Petri plates. We will be using MacConkey agar as an example. The grams per liter will vary depending on the final volume you want and the dehydrated culture media you are preparing. In order to make a batch of prepared media, you will need Pyrex flask at least double the size of the batch, stir bar, aluminum foil, dehydrated culture media, distilled or deionized water, hot stir plate combo, weigh boat, autoclave, sterile Petri plates, infrared no-touch thermometer, lighter. Be sure to use the oldest media first to keep your stock properly rotated. Do not use outdated media. The powder should be free-flowing and not clumped or caked. Culture media is extremely hygroscopic, which means that it pulls in moisture from the air quickly. Be sure to close the lid immediately after opening it and keep it tightly closed. Start by weighing the appropriate amount of dehydrated culture media for your batch into the weigh boat to make 1 liter of MacConkey agar. Select a flask that has a capacity that is 2 to 3 times larger than the volume you will be making. For example, if you are making 1 liter of media, then use a 2 or 3 liter flask. Transfer the weighed dehydrated culture media into a clean flask. Add a magnetic stir bar to the flask. Add 1 liter of deionized water. Use the water to wash down the sides of the flask if some of the powder is clinging to the glass. Cover the flask with foil. Place the flask on a hot plate stirrer. Bring the media to a boil while stirring using the magnetic stir bar. Be sure to mix and dissolve the media completely so there are no clumps. Boil the media for no longer than 1 minute. Boiling for a longer period of time will turn the media dark and damage the nutritional properties of the media. We are boiling just long enough to melt the agar. Be sure to use heat-resistant gloves when handling the hot flask to avoid burns. Place the flask of boiling media into an autoclave to sterilize. If your autoclave is equipped with a temperature probe, the temperature probe can be placed directly into the media and the cycle parameters will be based on the readings of the probe. Set the autoclave to 121 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes. Avoid overheating. If you are sterilizing large quantities of media, you may need to increase the time of the heating process. If you are sterilizing media that contains heat-sensitive ingredients, you may need to reduce the time or temperature of sterilization. This is why validation studies may be needed. When the cycle is finished, wait for the autoclave pressure to reach zero. Opening the door before the pressure has reached zero can be dangerous and can lead to spontaneous boiling of the media. If using a temperature probe, you should also wait until the temperature has reached at least 90 degrees Celsius or below to avoid the media boiling over. Remove the flask from the autoclave and place on the stir plate without heat. Be sure to wear gloves that cover your wrists as well as your hands when handling the flask. Stir mildly while cooling so as to not create bubbles. Cool the media to 45 to 50 degrees Celsius. You can check the temperature with an infrared no-touch thermometer. If your media formulation calls for the addition of supplements, add them aseptically now. Ensure the supplement was filter sterilized through a 0.2 micron filter before adding it to the flask. Make sure the supplements are first warmed to about 30 degrees Celsius before you add them. Otherwise, chipping of the agar can occur. aseptically dispense approximately 20 ml of media into sterile Petri plates. Ideally, do this in front of a HEPA-filtered clean bench. If one is not available, do the pouring in a room with minimal air currents in order to avoid contamination. If excessive condensation is a problem, cock the lids to the side to allow the water vapor to escape. Be sure to pour slowly as to not create bubbles. If bubbles do occur, then they can be popped with a flame from a lighter. Allow the plates to cool so that the agar will set up solid. This should take no more than 1 hour. If the plates will not be used immediately, store the plates upside down to avoid moisture from condensing on the agar surface. In this way, if there is condensation, it will form on the lid. Keep plates in a plastic bag until you are ready to use them. This will prevent moisture loss. Store the plates in the refrigerator at 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. Never freeze the media. The plates must be stored in the dark, since light can be damaging to the ingredients. As a sterility check, you can incubate several plates at 35 degrees Celsius to make sure there are no contaminants. Check them daily for at least 3 days. Most media plates have a shelf life of up to 3 months when stored properly, but it depends on the type of media. Validation studies must be performed. When washing your glassware, be sure that all detergent and soap residues have been thoroughly rinsed off. Rinse with deionized water, since any detergent residue could inhibit the growth of bacteria in future batches. We hope you have enjoyed our media making tutorial. Hardy Diagnostics manufactures a complete line of dehydrated culture media, known as Criterion. Check out our products in the links below. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for more tutorials and product videos. Remember to turn on the notification bell to be reminded of new videos as they are released. Hardy Diagnostics is 100% employee owned and has been serving microbiologists for over 40 years. To learn more about Hardy Diagnostics and the products we offer, visit us at hardydiagnostics.com.